Creating professional virtual tours with advanced features and custom functionality can be quite challenging and often requires extensive programming and IT knowledge. However, it can also be managed easily step by step using an intuitive interface and a creative approach, ideal for us photographers. In many of my previous in-depth tutorials, I guided you through professional shooting and editing processes for creating virtual tours. In this video, I'll introduce you the easiest virtual tour builder platform I've ever used, complete with all the latest upgrades and new functions. So, without any further ado, let's jump into it. TeliportMe is a cloud-based virtual tour software designed for professionals. It offers very unique and professional features while being easy to use even for beginners planning to start their own virtual tour business. So I'd rather say it's an intuitive software for anyone seeking for professional results. Let's take a closer look at the platform. TeliportMe has a brand new dashboard that is super clear, transparent and easy to use. You can navigate between your tours, street views, uploaded panels, domains, analytics and manage your team. In the domain menu, you can connect your tours to your own website, creating a custom subdomain. This means besides embedding your tour on a website, you can add a custom URL that leads directly to the virtual tour, complete with your own logo, menu and custom settings. But let's not get ahead ourselves. Let's see how to build custom virtual tours quickly and easily. After importing our panels, we can organize them by creating an order and even putting them into custom folders. In this instance, I don't have many panels, so I just put them in the right order. It's important because the tour will start with the first panel. In this case, I use the waiting room of this dentist clinic as the opening scene. I save the order and continue building the virtual tour. First, I select the default hotspot icon I will mostly use in the tour in the global settings. Then click on the menu of the tour and open the editor. Here I can see the first panel I set as the starting point, which is the entrance of this small clinic. I click on adding a hotspot to create the first transition. The selected hotspot icon appears and I can change its position, size and link it to my next panel. In this case it will be the corridor visible in the distance. I simply click on select and save. The name of this panel will appear on the screen, but I don't need it to be visible, so I delete it under the preview window. Although I set my favorite hotspot icon, I can select any other ones if needed. For instance, I can add an opening door icon to the door in the image. I click on the icon button, select and save it. Then I drag it to its place and resize it a bit to fit perfectly on the bathroom door, linking it to the bathroom photo. Linking the panels perfectly is also easy. Simply click on the button to change the view direction and move the panel to the ideal position. Here you can set what the viewers will see after clicking on the hotspot. After setting up your target photo, you can create a reverse hotspot, which means the software will automatically generate a hotspot going back to this panel. This can be speed up the workflow as you won't need to create every hotspot manually later. Besides adding hotspots to other panels, there are cool features like embedding videos, images and links. For instance, Magic Embed will create a layer inserted into the 360 space. In this case, I'll add an image on the empty TV screen on the wall. I simply set the corners and select Image. I can use any photos after uploading to the platform. I select and save it, and it appears on the screen as I imagined. I can even add borders if needed, which looks really cool in this case. Apart from this magic solution, I can add custom hotspots, also placed in the 360 space, which can be linked to further panels or even pop-up images or videos. This time I will add a pop-up photo to the reception desk. But your imagination is the only limit how to use this function. In practice, it looks professional in the panel if you provide close-ups of certain details or attach a traditional image related to that part of the tour. Now I'll move forward to the next panel by clicking on it on the bottom bar. As you can see, the reverse hotspot is already there, pointing backwards to the entrance. Here I can refine its position and continue connecting further locations. I add hotspots and link them to the corresponding images, delete the photo names, set the directions, and add reverse hotspots in each case, building the virtual tour quickly and easily. I place my entry hotspots on the floor, and inside the small rooms, I put a door hotspot to the exits. I click on the automatically created reverse hotspot, reposition it, click on the icon, and select and save the door icon. Double-checking the directions within the tour is crucial, so I make sure I do my best. I quickly set up everything, clicking on each panel one by one on the bottom bar. If I feature multiple images in one room, I can add further panels. I can add creative elements to any panoramas, customizing these objects and placing them in the 360 space, enhancing the value of our virtual tour. We can add further elements like a virtual host video, a custom logo, a welcome screen, a dollhouse model, or a custom menu. Or we can add extra protection by adding a password option. Let me show you the coolest solutions. Adding a menu can help use the virtual tour as a standalone website, allowing visitors to navigate easily, even if we upload a complex structure of information. This menu can be fully customized for a unique look. Uploading a logo helps in customization. It can be your own logo or your partner's logo. Another cool feature is the welcome screen, where you can add a custom image and custom text as title and description, adding a professional look to your virtual tour and making it high quality in standalone mode as a website. As you can see, there are tons of fonts to choose from, so you can deeply personalize everything, creating a branded look for your virtual tour. Visitors will be able to enter your tour after viewing your welcome page and clicking on the start button. On the tabs above the preview, you can switch between the blocks you have and check all the blocks you've created. You can delete and open them one by one or add further blocks. Now let's create a dollhouse view, a unique feature in this genre. As you've seen on my channel, I've made tutorials on 3D scanning apps, but this is something different. This dollhouse is more than a spectacular attraction. It serves the virtual tour by giving an extra feature and another point of view for the viewers. You can add rooms one by one and place them in 3D. Each panel will be a separate room, and you connect them by fitting their boxes next to each other in the right direction. You can add levels, but in this case it will be a simple model with a single level and 6 rooms. When it's done, you can finalize your virtual tour. In the tour details, you can change the look of your platform by changing the location of the panels on the screen. You can create a bottom bar or sidebar or hide the panels of the tour, allowing viewers to navigate using the hotspots or select locations in the menu. The user interface is also fully customizable. You can turn on and off panorama details, hiding or revealing the name of your panoramas on the screen. I will hide them here, just like deleting them from the hotspots. You can also add a VR mode icon to enable viewing with a headset. In this case, I'll turn off the info and disable the ability to create screenshots of the virtual tour. As you can see, it's a simple but good-looking virtual tour with a customized logo, a navigation bar at the bottom, and custom hotspots. A more complex tour can also be done quickly and easily, for instance by adding some menus as shown before. Besides these basic functions, you can add a dollhouse effect or floor plan visible on the right side of the screen. After building your dollhouse, you'll find its icon there, and clicking on it, you can enter the 3D view. You will see how the rooms are connected in the 3D space, and clicking on any of them, you can look around and switch back to virtual tour mode. As you can see in this tutorial, I only scratched the surface and still created a professional-looking virtual tour quickly and easily. And if you go deeper, adding iframes and smart bubbles, the sky is the limit. You still don't need to be an IT expert. I hope you like the idea of using this software, and if you'd like to try it with your own virtual tours, register and explore it for free. If you're interested in shooting and editing professional panels for virtual tours, check out my previous videos on this topic. And if you like this short tutorial, please give a thumbs up, and for more 360 content and tutorials, subscribe to my channel, push the notification bell, and see you next time.